Well, I'm back, Math 1. It's been a while. So let's start off with our Math 1 review. Got a final coming up. It's the end of the year, so I've created this page, this Google document with links that tie you right into Khan Academy, and you can practice these concepts because these concepts are on your final exam in about a week and a half. So one of the newest documents is the final review document. It's a PDF, and it's down here at the bottom. You see that? So that document is what you'll be accessing in class and working them out. Now, the questions themselves are multiple choice since it's a final, and we take a final the last day of school, so it's got to be scored really quick, so that's why it's multiple choice. Now, here is that guide. The guide is not complete. There are far more many questions on the final than this guide has, but it's a starting point. So I'd like to begin by looking at number one. All right. Now, we're going to find the slope of this graph. And this graph is linear, so we know that linear graphs have a slope defined by the rise and the run, right? The change in y over the change in x. And so we learn that we pick coordinates that are clearly marked. And that is, they intersect the grid at corners or where the horizontal and vertical grid lines intersect. So here's a clearly defined point right there. And also right here. So the rise and the run would be over to the right one, up three. And so my slope is 3/1. It also can be written as just 3. And to get a little more exotic with our answers, it could be defined as -3/-1. Also, those are all the same answer. So what's the multiple choice answer? Well, there it is. It's letter C. It has a slope of 3. And I hope that makes sense. Taking a look at another question. Which graph matches the equation y equals -2x+3? This question is pretty darn straightforward. We've learned this year that 3 is the y-intercept, right? Because this is in slope-intercept form. And so let's look for that 3 on the y-axis. So I see it here, and that's it. All the others are different y-intercepts. So I know the answer's got to be B, but let's verify. It says the slope here is -2, and that slope would be -2/1, or it can be written as +2/-1. And so that would be down 2 to the right 1, and there it is. That, in fact, is the right answer. So the graph is found at letter B. Got another question, number 3 here. It says, which justification was used for step 2? All right. Step 2 is a blank, and it looks like, if I'm looking at this process here, looks like we added 12 to get 21, right? And that's so sloppy, Mr. Jacobs. Clean that up. So it's the addition property of equality. Where's that at? Oh, there it is. Look, letter B again. So I'm going to take a pause there and begin later. It's about a 5-minute video clip. So like I always say, study hard, learn a lot, and we will see you soon. Bye-bye.